In the previous video, I have treated how to determine the performance limits of the aircraft as a function of altitude. Now, based on this, a figure can be constructed that shows at which combinations of speed and altitude an aircraft can fly. Now, one interesting point in this diagram is the maximum altitude. In this situation, the aircraft limits, maximum airspeed and minimum airspeed, have converged into a single point. Now, today I will make an example derivation which shows how to determine this maximum altitude based on some basic aircraft data. Now, based on these calculations, we will also be able to reason what the optimum shape is of an aircraft designed for high altitude flight. Now, at first, I'm going to assume some characteristics of the aircraft. In terms of its engine, I'm assuming that thrust, so the actual thrust, divided by the thrust level the engine can generate at the stratosphere, equals the air density, the current air density, divided by the air density at the stratosphere. So this is a simple relation which we already used before. Now for the aerodynamics, I am going to assume a simple one-term lift drag polar. In most of my derivations I use a two-term polar, but for this derivation I'm going to use a slightly simpler, which is CD is CD0 plus a factor K times CL squared. And if we take this simple representation, you can also say, well, this is CD0 plus CL squared divided by pi AE. If you're interested, you can also try the derivation with a two-term polar, but you will get more or less the same result as I will show you here. Now, if we are in cruise flight, we can state that lift is equal to weight and thrust is equal to drag. So this would be cruise at the maximum altitude. Now, by combining this, you can state that drag is drag times lift divided by lift. And since, so I'm multiplying it by one, and since lift is equal to weight, we can also say, well, this is in fact CD over CL times the weight. And this must equal thrust according to our horizontal equilibrium. Now, I'm going to take this equation here and take this thrust and replace it in the equation we already derived. So what this means is that I can also write this as 1 over the thrust level at the stratosphere times CD over CL times the weight equals air density divided by the air density at the stratosphere. And please note that this thrust level the engine can generate at the stratosphere and this air density at the level of the stratosphere and also the aircraft weight, they are all constant for a given moment in time during cruise flight. So if we are interested to fly as high as possible, we should have minimum air density. And we can write this as the air density at the stratosphere divided by the thrust level at the stratosphere times CD over CL times the weight. And since we are interested in minimum air density, we can also state that CD over CL should be minimum. Or, in other words, we can state that CL over CD should be maximum. Now that makes sense, right? We have to fly in the most efficient aerodynamic configuration to reach the maximum altitude. Now, we already know from previous lectures that if we have this lift-drag polar, then the solution for optimal lift over drag ratio is CL equals the square root of CD0 divided by this factor K. And if you cannot remember that derivation, just take some time to have a second look at our earlier videos. Now this also means that if I take the lift drag polar, then CD is CD0 plus this CL squared, which is CD0 divided by K squared divided by pi A E, right? And if we try to solve this equation, then we know that this K is equal to 1 over pi A E. So, in fact, all this K is removed against these terms, and we obtain that CD is actually 2 times ZD0. Quite a nice final result for the aerodynamics. But we're not just interested in the aerodynamics, we're interested in finding the minimum air density. And this is air density at the stratosphere divided by thrust at the stratosphere times CD. And we know this is 2 times CD0 divided by CL, which we already calculated right here, which is the square root of CD0 times pi A E. So that's that 1 over K. And we have to multiply this with the weight. Now, a final step to come to the result is I'm going to take this CD0 and put it within the square root. So I'm just making how we write this slightly simpler. So we still have rho S divided by TS, and then I get a factor 2, and I get one big square root where I have CD0 divided by pi A E times the weight. So this is our final result. We have a relationship between the minimum air density we can reach with several constant parameters that describe the aircraft. So what does this mean? Actually, we want this aspect ratio to be quite large. What we also want is we would like this weight to be quite low in order to reach a high altitude. And we also like this CD0 to be small. And finally, we would like to have an engine which is able to deliver a high amount of thrust at high altitude. And this basically concludes the derivation that I would like to do about calculating the maximum altitude of an aircraft. So, concluding, it is possible to determine the maximum altitude of an aircraft if the lift drag polar is known and the engine characteristics as a function of altitude. Now, based on the calculations, we determined that it is beneficial to have a high aspect ratio wing and an engine which is able to operate at very low atmospheric temperatures and at low air density. Now, a nice example of an aircraft designed for high altitude flight is the Lockheed U-2, which is in fact a reconnaissance aircraft. Now, this aircraft was able to fly so high that enemy air defenses could not do anything about it when this plane was flying over their country. And you can see clearly that this aircraft indeed has a high aspect ratio wing. In addition, it can be said that this aircraft was designed for minimum weight. Now, the service ceiling of this aircraft is above 21 kilometers, and at this altitude, the pilot even has to wear a spacesuit. Now, this concludes our example calculation for the maximum altitude.